Hi, welcome to Movie Review with Daniel. Today I'll be doing a movie review on Netflix Desperados. While Netflix have been trying, and in my opinion mostly failing, to resurrect the romantic comedy, it has also been quietly attempting to reinvigorate a subgenre that studio have spent even less time and money on. When Bridesmaid became Jude Apatow's biggest ever hit as producer or director, scooping up unearned huge reviews and two Oscar nominations along the way, many expected that more could follow. Studio comedies that centered on groups of female friends who were allowed to be more than just idealist or demonic girlfriend and wife. But it's been a slow slog for the past decade, scattered with just Girls Trip, Rough Night, and Two Bad Moms film, both clearly awkwardly written by straight men, leaving Netflix to pick up the slack. The film Desperado is about Wesley, a 30-year-old who is not living the life she wanted, unemployed, single, and stealing the food of children she babysits for. When she finds out her ex is getting married, she's determined to make a sudden friend engineer setup work. But on the date, she lets herself be a little too candid, and he quickly shares his lack of interest. On her way out of the bar, she trips and is promptly saved by a handsome stranger, Jared, played by Robbie Amell. A whirlwind romance ensues, but when Jared goes away after their first sex, she's convinced that yet another guy has ghosted her. With the help of her two best friends, Brooke and Carl, played by Anna Camp and Sarah Bones, and so far too many bottles of wine, she decided to send a furious email calling out his perceived bad behavior as well as his other faults. Please stop hashtagging all of your Instagram hashtag photograph. Everything on Instagram is a photograph. But just as the sex buzzing is being pressed, he finally hears from him in the hospital. He was in an accident in Mexico which left him in a coma, unable to reach her, and is here to check his phone, which is locked away in his hotel room. And so, being a frantic, ill-advised trek to Mexico, as the three try to find his room and prevent him from seeing just how unhinged Wesley can be, it is this desire to disguise the real, messy, drunk, angry, irrational you from someone you have just started dating. That's one of the sharper observations in the film that too often opts for easy, dumb laughs. After being too real with guys and drive them away, Wesley pretends to be what she thinks a man like Jared wants, a passive salad-eating housewife in training who doesn't ever lose her cool. Jared's good looks and superficial maturity, he wants kids and owns a duvet cover, makes his regressive gender exception more palatable, as well as Wesley's age and exhaustion at the process of dating. It is all complicated further when an early bird date, Sean, also happens to be at the same resort, especially as he's already seen the real Wesley. The script from TV writer Ellen Rappaport provides Pritchard with many opportunities to embarrass herself, but it is the smaller moments that stick rather than the more exaggerated physical comedy. Signposted Pratt falls a constantly on funny running joke, but Wesley being a pedophile and a bizarre scene involving a dolphin penis all proved awesome, like they were grafted on from the Fairy Brother film Psycho, the late 1990s. Why Predat can make for an SLS sketch comic, and why there's an easy chemistry between her and Morris, she plays too much of the film with a sitcom level broadness, causing one to wonder what an actor with a more believable specific awkwardness could do with the role. It is not hard to compare to Kristen Wiig, another SNL comedian who played a similar can't get her shit together role in Bridesmaid. But Wiig is a skilled tragicomic actor, able to modulate more delicately between big and small, able to evoke sympathy and laughter in the tiniest of facial movement. Thanks for watching today's review. Please feel free to hit the like and subscribe button and leave your comments in the comment box below.